morning. Here we are on the back deck on Saturday morning, and it's time to read Matthew 12, 22 to 32. Let me just get that up real quick. Here we go. And here we go. Then a demon-oppressed man who was blind and mute was brought to Jesus, and Jesus healed him, so the man spoke and saw. And all the people were amazed and said, "Can this be the son of David?" But when the Pharisees heard it, they said, "It is only by Beelzebul, the prince of demons, that this man casts out demons." And knowing their thoughts, he said to them, "Every kingdom divided against itself is laid waste, and no city or house divided against itself will stand. And if Satan casts out Satan, he is divided against himself. How then will his kingdom stand? And if I cast out demons by Beelzebul, by whom do your sons cast them out? Therefore they will be your judges. But if it is by the Spirit of God that I cast out demons, then the kingdom of God has come upon you. Or how can someone enter a strong man's house and plunder his goods, unless he first binds the strong man? Then indeed he may plunder his house. Whoever is not with me is against me, and whoever does not gather with me scatters. Therefore I tell you, every sin and blasphemy will be forgiven people, but the blasphemy against the Spirit will not be forgiven. And whoever speaks a word against the Son of Man will be forgiven. But whoever speaks against the Holy Spirit will not be forgiven, either in this age or in the age to come." So here, you know, the people are amazed when Jesus does this healing. And they say, could this be the Messiah? Maybe he's the Messiah. Of course, the Pharisees instantly say, no, fake news, it's not true. He's doing it by the power of Satan. And Jesus says, well, if I'm working against evil by the power of evil, how is that productive? It's counterproductive. A kingdom divided against itself won't stand. And so he kind of calls them out on that and says, you know, it's not fake news, it's the truth. I'm doing this, but I'm doing it by the Spirit of God. And give several examples, you know, about kingdoms divided against themselves and plundering a strong man's house. And then he ends up by saying, you know, you can blaspheme all you want, but if you blaspheme against the Holy Spirit, it's not going to be good for you now or in the age to come. You're not going to be forgiven that blasphemy. So be careful what you say and do. Don't work against the Spirit. And I think this is important because we see the reception that Jesus gets among the people. They're thinking, wow, he might be the Messiah. And of course, the Pharisees, who are the educated class, they're like, no, he's not. Yeah, forget it. He's not. He's not the one you want to follow. And so they don't follow him, or they won't follow him, and they end up working against him and eventually having him killed, frankly. And so Jesus knows this is coming, and he knows that this battle is going to go on. He knows that he's not going to win this fight in earthly, temporal terms. He's going to win, of course, sort of cosmically when he comes back from the dead. But they don't know any of that. And so all of that is building. Meanwhile, Jesus says, you know, the blasphemy against the Spirit won't be forgiven. And so you need to be careful what you say and do, and don't blaspheme against the Spirit. If the Spirit is leading you to do something, you need to be responsive and be with the Spirit and do that thing. Because if you don't, the Spirit's going to move on and leave you behind. And that's important for us and for the church. We need to be sure that we are listening to the Spirit all the time and not doing things because it suits us. Long time ago, I was involved with planning a contemporary worship service, and the group planning it decided that we were going to do it at 9 o'clock on Sunday mornings. And they also wanted it to be an outreach to people who don't come to church. And one of our people, who was kind of an expert in this stuff, said, you know, you got to do the service when the people that you're targeting, that you want to invite, will actually come to the service. And they're not going to come at 9 o'clock in the morning. And they didn't. They're going to come at, you know, 2 p.m. or something. It's going to be later in the day. But that's when it suits us to do it, so that's when we did it. And we had a good time, we had a good response. We just never got those unchurched people that we had wanted to come, because we were following our own desires and preferences and stuff. So when the church does that, sometimes it works against the spirit, and that's what we want to avoid. Well, we've gone way long today, so I hope that you have a good day, and we will... see you. I'm going to Camp Greer today, so I'm going to post this video now, and tomorrow's I'm going to schedule it, and so we'll see you later. Bye-bye.